ELISpot plates of the MSIP model, no matter if they are fresh coated or pre-coated, comes with an underdrain attached to the bottom of the plate. This is a piece of soft plastic that is put there by Millipore and relates to their use as filtration plates in other types of applications. While filtration is never used in the ELISpot assay, we still have to consider three points related to the underdrain and how it can affect your ELISpot data if handled incorrectly. First, never put excessive pressure on the backside of the underdrain with your hands. Throughout your experiment, handle the plate by holding its edges, not its underside. Do not use excessive force when gripping the plate. You see, the underdrain is of a rather soft structure, so a very firm set of fingers can unfortunately lead to the plastic flexing back into the backside of the membrane, causing imprints to the PVDF membrane. The exact nature of these imprints we will come back to later. Second, avoid using excessive amount of force when emptying the plate. A firm tap is of course fine for removing small amounts of PBS or water, but you should never whip the plate ferociously into a hard surface with only thin sheets of paper covering it. In this video, little power is used, so obviously no problems here, but pushing it too hard can actually make the membrane flex backwards at the point of impact, and again cause imprints to the PVDF membrane. And finally, in our Mabtech protocol, we do not explicitly state that the underdrain must be removed following spot development. In fact, in my experience, the only downside to keeping the underdrain in place is that it will take longer time for the plate to dry. Nevertheless, many users desire a faster drying time and will attempt to remove the underdrain. Let us show you the right technique of how to do it using the pincer tool in the video. We begin by attacking one of the underdrain corners. Notice how the technician undoes the underdrain by using the wiggle technique. This is very important because simply pulling straight and hard can make the ELISpot membrane rupture. We don't want that. Furthermore, notice how the technician is holding the plate, not putting any pressure on the backside of the underdrain. This is absolutely essential if you want to avoid contact between the wet PVDF membrane and the inner structures of the underdrain. Rather much force is necessary to be used during underdrain removal, and if this force is directed towards the underdrain backside in any way, artifacts may become visible. Let us together check out some real-life examples of some typical underdrain-induced artifacts. Here we have two images of a human interferon gamma ELISpot that has these typical signs or hallmarks of an ELISpot plate that has not been handled correctly. In the unstimulated control to the left, the artifacts are very obvious, but you can also make them out in the antigen-stimulated well to the right if you look carefully. These unspecific dots will get counted by most readers at a low setting, and as a result, the user must spend several hours manually deleting them. Very tedious work. One might ask, why do we get four unspecific dots from the inner structures of the underdrain? Well, let's go back to the video and inspect the removed underdrain a little bit more in detail, closer to it. Let us freeze the video for a moment right there. See that? Inside of each well, you can see four lines, forming something of a cross. However, the cross is not fully flat, it has a 3D structure to it if you look closely. The highest points of the cross coincides with the placement of the membrane artifacts shown earlier. In essence, this is the point of contact between the underdrain and the PVDF membrane if the plate is handled incorrectly somewhere during the assay. By looking at this video, you should now be well equipped to avoid any such problems. Bye bye.